good, brother. Give them, you know. Good, brother.
Come on, that's where the Lord is going.
Anything like they were using?
Yeah, that's what I was using.
God, look at
that. This is what I was going.
You need to break it.
Go on with the wire out first. Oh, you're not taking it. I'll leave that one.
I've had a pair of these lying about for a while.
No, this is all
over. I just thought they were far too big for talking.
Depends if the junior's hooking to the heron again though.
What, the junior's going for it?
I might hook into him.
Let's put this way. Mix over in his boat.
Does he? Does he want any of those?
No, he said he didn't want
it. Too much bother with him, mate. Yeah. Yeah. He spent the Zerino.
Good feathers. That's
oh well. Your boats.
It's alright if your boat's here.
What boat you
on? Encounter. Okay. He's just coming down, so.
Tackle box.
All right.
They
need your tackle box.
That's it.
So how you placed from yesterday?
Pardon?
How are you placed from yesterday?
Well, there's only two ladies out. So.
So how are you placed from yesterday?
First.
We are first from yesterday. That's good. Feeling confident today?
The weather's not so good, but.
Well, maybe good for fishing.
Maybe. I directed.
Thank you.
clever.
Starboard side, stern.
Aye, starboard side, stern. Odd numbers.
Odd numbers on the port side.
Odd numbers on the port side.
It's all further. One's right in the front, is it?
Thank you.
three of them here. They all stay on. Only another 23 to go.
I'm going into the box.
Right?
Yep.
I've gone over to fresh mackerel bait because it was a bit tougher than the sand eels and they were being pulled off. There's so many fish down there.
Okay.
Just wait till I hook one, I'll let you know when I... Garnard, I said. Grey Garnard.
Hold up to the camera, let's see.
Or is it a grey Garnard? It's somewhere between a grey and a red, I think. It's a grey Garnard. Gotta watch the spikes.
Thank you.
chance to use the rod master.
said to our
coffee.
He said to our coffee.
Where's the coffee?
Oh, right, I thought it was...
No zone, I'm...
I'm going to grab that open bag with a live LSD in it.
Filming!
You filming this?
Just shove it in front of the camera, I think.
Yeah?
How did you get on the day, Joe?
I'm at a good time. Oh, dear.
Just about the same.
So did you find the fish?
Yeah.
I mean, you're a skipper as well as an angler, so you must know where they are.
Yeah,
tell us
the
secret.
Well, we're over the ground every day. And we fish for bait for the creels anyway. Fish for the creels in it and pick up quite a bit of bait at the same time.
Did you find the haddock and herring today? What sort of catches did you have on the boat?
I think we may have the top in the championships yet. We had 16 caught today. We had quite a bit of herring as well, and white tuna. We had quite a good bag of fish.
Many fish, you reckon, you had?
In fact, you can see one of the bags here. That's
right.
One of the bags that I've caught today.
We had one or two bags today.
Let's go short bags.
We've got a good bag of cod and cold fish.
You had a good mixed catch today.
Yeah. We had the herring for a good while. We had the polies for one group. And then we've got a hitter to look at.
Any spur dog, anything like that?
Yeah, the spur dog. It's an old boat. It's a boat box.
Maybe that was a problem because we had quite a few spur dog, and I think when the dogfish are in, a lot of the other fish move off the ground.
No, we don't find that. What we find is the spur dog are there. They use shellfish bait or different bait from the mackerel bait. You'll get the haddock kind of weight in there. They're usually side by side. We think we're a bit of haddock.
Right, well, there. That looks like a good bank today.
Certainly better than Pitmeen. Aye. Better today than it was yesterday. Far better. Good skipper. Good track in the boat. But drag is still better than me today.
Quite a lot of cod too, John.
Yeah, 16 cod.
Over here, Neville. Sorry, John. John, you've got a good bang there as well today.
Yeah, 16 cod. Pollock and cornfish. Haddock, whitey. Oh, it was a good day.
Do you think the fish are quite local?
A lot around the peaks, isn't it? The hard, soft, hard ground is getting the drift right. Is all the secret, I think, really. And no one being in the right place at the right time is taking time. And pure blind luck.
You're saying it was a better day for you today than yesterday?
Certainly a better day today. Oh, much better. I think the fish was in a good mood for a change.
I think one or two of the boats found it was slower today.
Aye.
That's why I wondered whether it was...
Just a different mark, I think, that's about all. It's all to do with the fish and what you've been after at the right time. There's certainly a lot of fish about, but whether they're all feeding at the same time, that's it. The secret is being there when you're having to be feeding. That's all you need to really do. Getting your weights down and what they want. Or in our case, getting maybe some plastic down to them. That's all it was against.
Really, no bait at all, just artificials?
After about 11 o'clock, all rubber worms and bits of plastic. And that was it.
That's good. Saves time too, that, doesn't it?
Saves your back. I wish I'd known that before I started digging.
Personnel to come, and we had a request to lay on the facilities for the television crew, and we've been pleased because of the coverage this week to accept that request. Could I welcome all our visitors to our festival? Not forgetting the regulars, I seem to have to say this every year, but particularly this year, extend a welcome to all our new visitors, those who've come to our festival for the first time. I think you've all contributed tremendously to the 2 days and made it a very exciting and interesting competition. A word of thanks to certain groups who were involved. I'd like to thank our own shore team. Our committee was particularly decimated this week by holidays and so on. I think I'm beginning to wonder if some of them don't take the brochures in January, take the festival dates and start working out their holiday around that time. However, we did have sufficient members left to run the committee, to run the festival. Special thanks to our weigh-in team, who had to be revitalised at various stages in the process. All our sponsors are mentioned in the brochure. I won't name them, but our thanks to them all. prizes. The winner with 180 points won this one, David Proudfoot. Shield and a keepsake, there's a prize from the Festival Fund. Well done, John. The Ian Horn Trophy, you will notice a small tribute from the club to the late Ian Horn, who was a founder member of the club. The tribute comes at the beginning of your brochure. The trophy is presented to the member, the club member, who has the heaviest weight of fish on one day of the competition. And we're very pleased that this year it has been won by Joe Campbell of yesterday's weight.
Now, was that luck or skill?
A bit of both, I would say.
How's the competition organised?
Organized locally by the Stornoway Sea Angling Club. So a lot of work goes into it by the shore side. Yeah, they do very well.
Now you were out off the north of the island. You're obviously looking for quite a number of species of fish. How many species of fish were caught in the competition? Have you any idea?
In the whole competition, well, on our boat, one of the days we were out yesterday, it was 14 species. Today it was 8. So it's probably depends on the ground you're on.
And what kind of species were caught?
Cod, ling, pollock, holly, dabs, gurnards, mackerel, herring, scad.
That's the horse mackerel, isn't
horse
it?
Mackerel.
Scad, yeah. Now, herring's quite an unusual one. How are they normally caught?
Just on three bare hooks.
Bare hooks?
Three small bare hooks. Shiny, silver bare hooks.
Or hooks with any kind of shiny material on them?
Yeah.
Same thing as we'd get mackerel or coleys or maybe an odd pollock.
Yeah, but they go better for just a bare hook. No feather or nothing on them.
Small hook. So what were your tactics to fish this competition? Being a local man with local knowledge, what did you set out to do?
Well, I just went out to catch on the soft ground haddock and whiting. We knew haddock and whiting were in this year for the first time. We still haddock and whiting in the past 2 years. And we knew they were there because I work on a crab boat. And we fish now and again with the rods. And we knew the haddock and the whiting were a Korean log.
And did you get haddock today?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Paul Young. I was looking at cooking.
Your husband won the individual prize. It's a family success. How long have you been sea fishing?
Since I was about 15.
Now, it's not a normal thing for ladies to enjoy sea fishing. What is it that you enjoy about it?
Well, I started fishing when I was 11. I used to take me out fishing. We don't need to be out every day. The weather was good, and that's the best way to start.
But you quite enjoy going out in rough weather and catching fish?
Because I get used to the sea early.
Now, to win the ladies' prize in this competition, what did you get? What did you catch?
Just the same as we did with the boats catching. We had the boats. We had
And do you have any particular techniques that you use that your brother taught you when you were a kid? Exactly, and what are those techniques?
Just three hoops, nothing fancy,
What species did you catch?
Just a bit every species that was in.
And were you fishing bait?
Fishing bait, mostly sand eel, mussels.
Where did the sand eels come from?
There was a kind of
And what are you fishing, a single sand eel on a hoop?
Yeah, right.
And what fish do you get
Plastic
on
sand eel? Maybe.
What fish do you get on sand eel?
Well, I caught all the fish I caught was on sand eel.
It's a fabulous bait, of course. I mean,
that's what the fish eat.
How do you fish it?
On the bottom.
Sand eel on the bottom hoop? Tell me what your rig looks like when it goes down.
Well, I usually put the weight on the bottom.
And how do you bait them out?
Just sand eels in the tree.
Chairman of the Stornoway Sea Angling Club. Can you tell us a wee bit about it, about its history?
We're very proud of the history of the club. The club was founded in 1963. We had a very happy celebration 3 years ago when we were 25 years old, and I've been involved for all these years. I'm now chairman. The club has always had tremendous support from the community. I think we've provided, apart from anything, a little spectacle for them when they come to watch us do our weigh-in. We've had tremendous support from the local anglers. We carry a very large social membership as well, and I think we cater for all tastes.
What's your sort of day-to-day running of the club? How many outings a year do you have?
We have many fun outings. We divide our outings into two categories, what we call fun fishing and competitive fishing. Now, our competitive fishing extends over 7 months of the year. We have official monthly competitions with a league running. We have an official club championship event. And of course, the main one each summer, a two-day event, which attracts many visiting anglers.
So you've got your local anglers throughout most of the year, and you've got visiting anglers catered for during the summertime.
We also offer a temporary membership to visiting anglers, so they get full facilities in the club, access to boats and so on.
Now, tell us a bit about the fishing. What kind of fishing is available?
The fishing is very varied. In today's competition, for example, I understand we had 17 different species. Some of that is very good quality white round fish. Some days we get bonuses. We had magnificent turbot a couple of years ago. We've had one magnificent halibut of 70 pounds a few years ago. But generally, our anglers like to go out, catch enough to get into a league position, but also something for the deep freeze as well. So they do look for quality fish, and we often get them.
Now, we're in the headquarters of the Stornoway Sea Angling Club here, which is magnificent. It's a committee room, it's a bar. So is this a focus for people from
Very much a focal point. We've got a membership of usually of 400 to 500 each year. We're very proud of the club because it was built by voluntary effort at the turn of the 60s. Now we're running a small business. We can afford now to pay for jobs to be done, but in the early days, it was done with the sweat of our brow.
So how do you look back on the two-day competition that's just passed? Has it been a success?
Very successful one.
Tell us about the fish that have been caught.
We've had very good quality fish. We've had more than a ton and a half of fish from 55 anglers over the 2 days. This year we had quite a large number of herring. That's an indication I think, that the conservation policy is beginning to work. And the herring have been shoaling on the west coast. So much so that I think next year we'll look to restricting the number that the members can land.
Now, you're talking about conservation here.
how would the club apply a conservation policy to fish being caught, weighed on the boat and returned to the water? Is that something perhaps that
it's something where we're very dipping our toe into very gently at present. We follow the advice we're given from our parent body. We follow the law of the land as far as possible. And at present, common skate must be tagged and returned, tope must be tagged and returned. But we'll fall in line with whatever happens nationally.
So how do you see the future of the Stornoway Sea Angling
Club? I think it can only go on and on and on. We started off something in 1963. We had no idea it was growing to the present sort of, some people tend to call it a little monster, but no, I think it's. I think we've found a very valuable contribution to the community. And we've had tremendous support from the community. And the club has tremendous status in the town. We've had support from our local authority, from the Highland Development Board, but mostly from the people of Lewis and Harris who have supported us over the years.
That's what counts.
And many excellent visitors who keep coming back. We've got a contingent from Dover who've been coming since 1976. So
long may it continue.
We regard them as locals now.